Hello, Fisk. I see you get my chair nice and warm.
Mr. Manfredi, prison has not been kind to you.
That's an understatement. But now, I'm back to show you and the rest of this city who's top dog around here.
Look at yourself, Silvio. Your time for running this city is past years ago. You're not fit to keep the scum of this city in line.
Well, if that's the case, meet me at Times Square. We'll see who really runs this town.
What is the meaning of this invasion?
Sorry, Mr. Oscorp, but Oscorp is currently under investigation after one of your workers turned out to be the Tinkerer.
Oscorp has nothing to do with those terrorists.
But they were funneling your equipment and tech to make those weapons right under your nose. Once again, I'm sorry, but it's our job.
There's definitely something wrong with Mr. Robertson.
Are you okay, Mr. Robertson?
It's nothing, Peter. I just have a lot on my mind.
Oh. Well, is there anything I can help you with?
Peter, how did you come to grips with losing your uncle?
What do you mean?
I mean, if you played a part in your uncle losing his life, how do you keep going?
Well, my uncle had this philosophy that he held to pretty strongly. And it was one that served him really, really well. He believed that if there were things in this world that you had to offer, things that you did, well, better than anyone else, things that you could do that helped people or made them feel better about themselves? Well, he believed that it wasn't just a good choice to do those things. He believed it was your responsibility to do those things. I'm sorry, but I gotta get home. I hope that helped.
Thank you, Peter. Now I know what I need to do.
Aunt May must be out. God, I hope Aunt May picks up that corsage for Liz. DD? What is that? Oh no! Oh, no way!
Glad you could make it, Peter.
Oh my god, you are him!
Let's try not to announce it here.
Oh, right. My bad.
It's fine. Now please, come in.
I can't believe I'm in Daredevil's apartment. So is there like some secret room in the building where you keep your suit and stuff?
Of course. It's in a suitcase under one of the floorboards.
Oh. Well, are you actually blind? Does anybody else know you're Daredevil?
I am blind, and yes, some others know. Does anybody else know that you're Spider-Man?
Wait, you knew? How?
Both you and Spider-Man have a very strong heart. I'm assuming it's due to your spider abilities. It's unlike any other heartbeat I've heard before.
Really?
That, and that you both sound and smell the same. You should really tone it down on the Axe body spray. Go on and sit down, Peter. We've got a lot to talk about.
I'm assuming this has to do with Fisk, right?
You're a smart kid. Silvio Manfredi was released from prison about 2 days ago, and I have a feeling Fisk isn't going to be too happy with that.
Neither is the Underground. Or that guy with the skull painted on his shirt.
What?
That night Mr. Urich died, we were trying to stop Fisk and Tombstone from getting their hands on something dangerous. And out of nowhere, this guy with a skull on his chest walked in and started killing everyone. He called himself...
The Punisher.
Wait, you know him?
I've had a run-in with him. His name is Frank Castle, and he's insane. If he's getting himself involved in this too, then this may be more difficult than I thought.
Okay, well, what's the plan?
I'm gonna be stalking out Fisk Tower tonight, seeing if I can find anything.
Well, Mr. Murdoch, I know this is probably not a good time to ask, but do you think I should be involved with this?
What do you mean?
I mean that every time I try and stop Fisk, I screw up. And my last screw up ended up getting Mr. Urich killed. What happens if I mess up again and someone else gets hurt?
Listen, Peter. Ben thought for a long time that he was the reason Fisk killed Doris. But after a while, he realized that he couldn't blame himself. Because at the end of the day, Fisk is the one who ordered that hit. So he didn't let that stop him from making sure that Fisk saw justice. Now it's up to us to finish what he started.
Captain Stacy, we got someone here I think you're going to want to see.
Oh, who?
Captain George Stacy, I have some information about the Kingpin. Information that can take him down once and for all.
Mr. Jameson, you have to hear this.
Not now, Miss Brandt!
But Mr. Jameson, we just got an anonymous tip tying Wilson Fisk to the creation of Shocker, Scorpion, and Rhino.
What? Well, then what are you waiting for? I want it on my desk in 2.4 seconds!
Yes, sir.
I'll make this right.
Okay, Mr. Murdoch said he's gonna get some information on where Fisk's gonna be. Hopefully that's enough time to enjoy at least half of my homecoming.
Peter, I'm back with your tux. Now come on, let's get you ready for homecoming.
Showtime, Pete. Walk up to the door, tell her she looks nice, but not too much because that's creepy. And when I dance with her, I put my hands on her hips.
Well, you must be Peter.
Yeah, that's me.
I'm Liz's dad. It's good to meet you.
Yeah, nice to meet you too.
Oh, you got a really strong grip. Come on in.
Hi, Peter. You look very handsome.
Oh, thank you.
I'll go get Liz.
You look pale, Peter. Is everything okay?
I'm fine. Just kind of nervous.
Well, Liz is one of a kind, so I don't blame you. Wow. You look amazing.
Por favor, Papa, don't embarrass me.
She looks amazing. Right, Peter?
Yeah. You look really amazing.
Is that a corsage?
Yeah. It's for you.
Thanks, Petey.
I'll be driving you two, so let's get going.
Sir, you don't have to drive us.
It's okay. I have somewhere to go after.
It's a trap.
Of course it's a trap. Silvermane thinks I'm a damn fool. You've sent men to Times Square, right?
Peter, have I seen you somewhere before? Your voice just sounds...
He's friends with your boss's son.
Oh, really? Have you thought about interning at Oscorp?
Not really. I already have a job at the Daily Bugle.
Oh yeah, he's their photographer. He takes all the Spider-Man pictures.
Really? I've seen some of those pictures. They're impressive.
Thank you, sir.
So, how do you know where he's gonna be?
I had a friend who was following a story that involved Spider-Man. And he wanted me to get pictures for his story.
I'm glad Spider-Man is out there. He's a real hero.
Thank God for Spider-Man. You can head inside, Cariño. I want to talk to Peter for a second.
Don't let him scare you, Petey. Love you, Papa.
Love you too. Does she know?
Know what?
So she doesn't know. Good. Close to the vest. I admire that. I've got some secrets of my own. All the reasons I was worried about my daughter dating. Listen, Peter. You seem like a good kid. So I'll give you one chance. Are you ready? Walk through those doors. Forget any of this happened, and don't ever get in the way of my plans again. 'Cause if you do, I will kill you, and everybody you love. That's what I'll do to protect my family. Understand? Hey, I just saved your life. Now what do you say?
Thank you.
You're very welcome. Now go on, show my daughter a good time. Just not too good.
My dad didn't scare you, did he?
I am so sorry, but I have to go.
Go? What do you mean, go?
I'm so sorry. Come on, come on. Please still be here. Yes! Mr. Murdoch, are you staking out Fisk?
Yeah, Fisk is leaving right now. I'm gonna follow him and see where he stops.
Listen, I think I may have just figured something else out. Wherever Fisk is going, I think the Tinkerer in the Underground plan on being there as well.
This night just keeps getting better and better, doesn't it?
I'm gonna try and follow the Tinkerer, see if he'll lead me to Fisk. Then I can meet you there.
Okay. Good luck, Spider-Man.
Surprised?
Oh. Hey there, Peter. Sorry I didn't hear you come in.
It's over, Mason! I got you!
You know, I really admire your grit, Peter. Believe me, I did not have anywhere near the amount of grit at your age. No. I used to let people walk all over me. My parents, my professors, Osborne. But I guess we all need to grow a pair at some point. I see why Liz likes you. I really do.
How could you do this to her?
To her? I'm not doing anything to her, Peter. I'm doing all this for her.
Oh, sure.
Peter, you're young. You don't understand how the world works.
Yeah, but I understand that endangering lives is wrong.
I don't want to hurt anybody, but there's only one way to get Fisk, Silvermane, Hammerhead, and the rest of those parasites plaguing this city with their crime.
And you think more crime will make it better?
Crime is such a strong word for what the Underground do. More like revolution. Because there's only one way to stop these kind of people. People like you and me. We can't rely on people to fix the world for us. We can only trust ourselves to do it.
Why are you telling me all this?
Because I want you to understand. And I needed a little more time to get my newest project ready.
I'm sorry.
What are you talking about? That thing didn't even touch me!
I wasn't really trying to. Do you have a location? Get everyone ready. It's time.
Okay, ready? 3, 2, 1. Help! Help! Please, hey! Hey! Please! Please! I'm down here! I'm stuck! I can't move! I can't!
This was your plan, Silvio. Lure me out to have witnesses? You know that anything you do will result in you in a cell right next to mine.
Wilson. You remember when the words honor and loyalty were more than just words? When people in this town thought that if they even breathed the wrong way, the mob would put them down? I'm here to bring that fear back. So here's the bottom line. I'm taking back what was mine.
You old types always make it personal.
I did learn one thing. If you want to bring the fear back, you gotta make a strong entrance. Boys!
Underground here. Are you okay?
Fine.
Ugh!
So you're the Spider-Man I heard so much about. I expected better.
Oh, believe me, I'm full of surprises.
Hammerhead, we need to...
After this is over, it's my turn to take charge. Go to hell, Fisk.
It's over, Fisk. You're not going anywhere.
You're right. I can't leave without killing you.
Party's over! Because I made a promise.
All the civilians get out of here safely. Mulligan, you and your SWAT team get control of these thugs. Carter, set a perimeter around Times Square.
get off me!
Sorry, Silvio. Too many witnesses.
That sound. Hydraulic servos are powering Silvermane's armor. No hydraulics, no problem.
Cannot happen to Silvio Manfredi!
Well, somebody is a real sore loser. Then, I don't look the other way. Had enough yet, Willie? Captain George Stacy? Meet Wilson Fisk, a.k.a. the kingpin of crime.
Mr. Fisk, you are under arrest.
Next time, Frank. Next time. You did good work, Peter.
I still wish I could have done more.
You did all that you could. Sometimes not everything goes the way you want it. Trust me. I know what it's like. I know what it can be like to lose people.
Who'd you lose?
I lost my father. You?
My uncle.
He'd be proud of you, Peter.
Thanks. And your dad would be proud of you, too.
As of today, Wilson Fisk, aka the Kingpin of Crime, is officially behind bars. After the testimony of Daily Bugle employee Robbie Robertson and an anonymous tip sent to the Bugle, Fisk was found tied to the superpowered villains Shocker, Scorpion, and Rhino. Therefore, Wilson Fisk was announced guilty. In other news, billionaire Norman Osborn has announced earlier today his bid for mayor and his pledge to rebuild the damage in Times Square, saying, quote, "Let's bring the city back to its former glory," end quote.
Hey guys.
Hey, Pete. What happened to you at homecoming?
About that, I... Just give me 1 second. Liz! Liz, wait, just listen to me for a second. Look, I know what I did at homecoming was a really crappy thing to do.
You're right. It was a really crappy thing to do.
Listen, I'm really sorry about homecoming and about your dad. Finding out that he was the tinkerer, I can't imagine what that must be like for you.
Well, I'll just have to learn to come to terms with it. I'm moving, Peter.
What?
My dad doesn't want me, my mom, and my brother all there for his trial. Said he doesn't want us to see him like that. We're leaving after I get home. The movers already have all of our stuff packed.
Liz, I am so sorry.
Whatever is going on with you, Peter, whatever is keeping you so distracted from your friends, I just hope you figure it out. Bye, Peter.
How did it go?
Not great. I don't really know if she forgave me or if she hates me. Aunt May, does adult life ever get easier?
Parts of it do. Other parts never get easier. Believe me, I've had to make plenty of sacrifices to fulfill my responsibilities. And I've had many hard times before we lost Ben. But if we can't keep smiling when others can't, then we might as well be gone too.
She's right. We can't dwell on our past mistakes and regrets. Or the people we've lost. Because they'd want us to keep going. Want us to keep living our lives. And this is how I want to live my life. Tell me there's something better. Go on. Try. Thank you.
Are you sure he'll be pleased with this one?
Yes, I'm certain.
I ask for an equal. And after weeks of your searching, this is what you find.
Sir, we may have found a new hunting ground.
Rumor has it that this one was strong enough to defeat all of the others.
Finally. The great hunt begins.
Keep on rising, we're never gonna stop. Yeah, we keep on shining, shining.